Hey everyone, greetings from the Western Idaho Fair. That's where I'm performing this weekend. And I want to teach you a new origami model, but first I want to show you a little bit of unicycling. Okay, all right. And now I'm going to show you the model for this week. It is, check this out. It is a cross? No, it's a person swallowing a sword. And here it goes. There it is. A person swallowing a sword. Now this is just a paper sword, you know. But you want to see the real thing? Well, we just have someone here that might show you. This is Dan Meyer, and he's going to demonstrate real sword swallowing. Check it out. Oh my gosh, all the way in. Oh, okay, I'm going to take it out. Ooh, whoa, whoa.
Oh yeah.
Huzzah. Ooh, all right, there's a sword, but I don't think I'm going to teach this sword on that. Ooh, I almost fell. But you want to learn how to fold this one? Ready, set, here goes. All right, so here's the sword swallower that I'm going to try to teach you. And this is a pretty difficult model, especially the sculpting. So if you want a challenge, then here goes. So this particular model, I used a 10-inch square of kami, but I colored the white side silver. So that ends up with a silver sword and silver hair. But for this tutorial, I'm going to just use an ordinary 10-inch square of kami, and that'll give you a model that looks like this, with a purple face and a white sword and hair. So let's begin colored side up, and let's fold in half. Try to make really sharp creases and fold precisely. And now let's fold this edge to here. By the way, I got bitten by a vampire bat. Just kidding. I fell off my unicycle. I hope I don't gross you all out. All right, now let's fold this edge to the top. And when you do, try to hold this paper down so it doesn't slide up like that. Just let's try to make really exact folds. And let's rotate 180 degrees and let's fold this edge to the top. And let's turn over right to left and let's fold this edge to the top. Okay, and now let's completely unfold. And let's rotate so that all of these vertical creases are on top. And now let's fold this edge to this crease. So we're folding right on this crease. And just fold between these two points. And let's rotate 90 degrees. And let's fold this up right on this crease. And make the two creases come together and let's pinch right here and make this flap just stick straight up like that. And let's do the same thing on this side. So let's rotate and let's fold this edge to here. We're reversing this crease. And let's make the point stick up. Okay, and let's rotate it back like this and turn over right to left and let's fold this edge to here. So now we're folding on this crease. And let's fold this edge to here and make this flap stick up and rotate and let's fold this edge to here, reversing this crease. Make this flap stick up. And now let's fold both of these flaps down and flatten. And
And let's turn over right to left. And let's rotate 90 degrees. And let's pull this edge to here. And rotate 180 degrees. And let's pull this to here. And let's turn over top to bottom and rotate 90 degrees. And now let's open up this pocket right here. And let's fold this edge up to here. And push on these two points. So it goes up like this and flatten. And let's fold the flap back down. And let's fold these two corners to this point. And unfold the two corners and rotate. And now let's fold in half, but let's open this pocket. And now fold in half. So this point comes up like this and flatten. Okay, so that's what it should look like. And now let's rotate 90 degrees and let's fold this top flap up so that this edge aligns with this edge. And unfold and let's open, and we're going to reverse this flap. So just push it in like this and fold on the existing crease and close it back up. And now let's unfold this flap up like this. This will just stick up, don't worry about that. And now let's fold this top flap up so that this edge goes to the crease. And unfold, and let's open, and let's push this flap inside, reverse it, and flatten. And now let's fold this flap up, flatten, and fold it back down. And now let's fold the flap back like it was, close it up. And now let's hold this flap in your left hand and hold these flaps in your right. And holding it like this, just pull your hands apart and make this fold right on the crease like that. And now let's pinch these two edges together. And pinch these two edges together. And pinch, pinch, pinch until they come together right there. And flatten. And there we have a longer flap, which will be part of the handle. Okay, now let's turn over. And let's do the same thing on this side. So let's fold this flap up so that this edge aligns with this edge. And unfold and open here and let's reverse it. Open here and let's reverse this flap. So first fold it up so that this edge goes to the crease. And unfold and open and let's push it in, reverse it and flatten and fold this flap up and back down and close this back up like that. And now let's hold this flap in your right hand and hold these two flaps in your left and pull your hands apart and make the fold and pinch here and here and flatten it down. Okay, now let's fold this flap up and turn over and fold this flap up. And let's open right here and turn over. And let's fold this point to this crease. Like that. And turn over again and fold in half. And now let's fold this flap down and turn over and fold this flap down. And now we're going to rabbit ear this flap. So let's first fold the flap over so that this edge aligns with this crease. And unfold, and let's fold it again so that this edge aligns with the crease. And unfold. And now let's make this fold and this fold, and let's squeeze it so that these two points come together. Or so these two edges come together. And flatten. Like that. And let's turn over, and let's do the same thing with this flap. So let's fold this edge to the crease. And unfold, and let's fold this edge to the crease. And unfold, and fold on this crease, and let's squeeze so that this edge aligns with this edge. Okay, and now zoom out a little bit. And let's fold this flap down. And fold it back up. And now let's fold this edge so that it aligns with the crease. So we're taking this whole flap and folding it to the right. And unfold. And now let's fold the whole flap to the left. So once again, we're folding it so that this edge aligns with this crease. And unfold. And now let's fold this edge to this edge. And we're just taking this flap, right, like this, and folding it up. And it goes from here all the way to where the two creases come together. So we have three creases coming together, and this is a rabbit ear, a really long rabbit ear. And flatten it down like this. Okay, so here is the sword, but as you notice, this side is a lot shorter than this side. So we're going to try to effectively pull it out so that it's symmetrical. So let's unfold this flap, and let's fold this edge to this crease. And you just need to fold right where the paper is the thickest, right there. Just give it a nice tight pinch. And unfold, and let's rotate. And let's do the same thing on this side. So let's fold this edge to this crease. And just give it a nice pinch right there. And unfold, and let's rotate back. And let's fold it up like it was. And now let's zoom in. And here comes the challenge. So what we want to do is hold it like this, and let's pull it out, and let's pinch these two edges together. So just give it a nice pinch like that. And now you want to pull it out so that this crease right here aligns with this edge. So you fold it like this. Hold it like this and just pull. We're pulling this whole flap out. And inside, you see it'll get deformed in there. However it works, it's okay. It's not going to be visible. So just pull it out. Make it as long as this flap. And this is what it looks like from underneath. And flatten. Okay, so here we have the handle of the sword. And I don't know what this part is called. I guess this is the handle. Okay, let's fold this point in like that. And the same thing over here. And unfold and unfold, and let's reverse these flaps. So just push it in like this. And open here. And push this in. And now it looks like a cross. Well, we can make it look more like a sword later. But now let's work on the action. So let's zoom out. And let's fold this down. And now let's fold this flap so that this edge aligns with this edge. So we're just folding it right like this. Okay? And now we're going to slide the paper up. We're just rolling the paper right here. Just using your thumb and index finger, roll it up so that the handle just slides up like this. And you want to just loosen this paper. It shouldn't go any further down like that. No, not like that. Just stop right here. Just make it go up and down like that. And let's rotate. If you want, you can use your right hand, thumb and index finger. Just bring it up and down like that. And let's make it go a little bit further up. And it can go almost all the way. If you want, you could go all the way, but I like stopping right like that. If it goes like that, it might mess it up. So this is just a little bit more reliable. And yeah, just spend a few minutes just working it in, making it nice and loose. Okay, so that's pretty good. And now let's unfold this. And let's fold these flaps back down. And this can just stay like that. Don't try to unfold it. And let's pull the two flaps out. And zoom out so you can see what I'm doing. Okay, pull the two flaps out like this. And now let's lift up this top layer right here and just bring it up like that. And we want to make this middle fold be a mountain. So just push it up like that and fold it. And let's continue this mountain fold all the way down here. So just make that mountain like that. And let's fold these flaps down like this. And now we're going to flatten these flaps, and this is how to do it. You want to rotate, you want to rotate this corner to the right and flatten it so that this crease aligns with this edge. So it's just like that. And flatten it. So this edge should be parallel to this crease. And flatten it over here too. Okay, and turn over, and let's do the same thing on this side. So flatten this flap so that these two corners come together, and so that this crease lands on this edge. Okay, and now let's open here and open right in here. And we're just going to squash this down like this. And now let's turn over. And this is going to be the nose. And let's try to make it not as pointy. So what we're going to do is open here and just change this fold to bring it up like this. It should still go through this point. Just like that. And refold it. And let's do the same thing on this side. So we're going to change this mountain and just bring it over like this. And try to make it symmetrical. All right. And now we're going to rabbit ear it. And this is a challenging little fold, and it really does affect how the final face looks. So just do your best to do what I do. Let's fold this corner to right about here. Like that. And unfold. And let's fold this corner to right about here. And when you do, try to make the paper so that it doesn't slide down like that. Just really pretend like it's a single layer. Okay, and now let's make our rabbit ear. So fold both at the same time and try to keep it flat. That and like that, and try to make it symmetrical. So that's going to be the nose. And now let's lift this flap up. Just put your finger into this pocket right here, and what we're going to do is invert this point right here. So we're going to invert it so that it goes inside and touches this point. So just with your finger inside here, just push it in. Oh, you want to make sure that the nose stays down. So we're holding it like this. And we want to push it in so that it connects with this point. Like that. Okay, so that's what it looks like. And now let's open here and let's remake this fold. So just rabbit ear it on the existing creases and fold it to the right And let's fold this flap down. And now we're going to attach these two flaps together, and this is how we're going to do it. Bend this flap down and fold this one up, and we want these two points to come together, except that we want this flap to be in this pocket right here. So let's bring it up and stick it in the pocket and slide it in, and we want this edge to align with this edge. So keep sliding, and you also want to make sure that this crease aligns with this crease. Just take your time, work it in. Okay, so it's like that. And now hold really tightly here so that it doesn't come undone. And now we're going to lock it by folding this flap behind. So fold it behind, and you want it to come to this point, like this. And this edge should be parallel to this edge. Like that. And let's fold this flap inside. Just fold it behind. Okay. And now let's open here, make this convex, and open here. So just put your finger in here and push in here. So here we have the two eyes, and this is the forehead, and the face is taking shape. Okay, now let's work on the cheekbones. So let's make a valley fold. Just squeeze right here. And we want a valley fold that starts at this point and goes up here. It should be parallel to this edge. So here goes. And it should just be on the outermost layer. So I'm just putting my finger in the pocket right here. And there's the cheek. And let's do the same thing on this side. So put your finger into this outermost pocket. And we're going to make a valley fold that goes from this point up. Like that. And now just reach in to both of the cheeks and try to make the cheeks bulge out like this. So we're just shaping them from behind. So it's like that. And now let's reach in and open the mouth. If it's really small, if you're using 6-inch paper, then you might need to use a pencil like that. But my finger fits in here just fine. And let's do the same thing on this side. Put it in like this. And open the mouth. Okay. Now, let's fold this edge in. This sort of makes the lips. And fold the cheek back a little bit. And like this on this side. Just fold it to taste. like that. If you want, you can try to flatten this part right here. And the way you can do that is just take the end of a paintbrush and stick it into this pocket. And be careful not to tear the paper. And just try to mold this like that. Okay, and you can shape the nose. Make it 3D. It's a nice curve. And same on this side, just try to make it symmetrical. And so that looks pretty good. Now, on this model, you can see I pushed the eyes back out, and that is really challenging. I think it looks the cleanest, the easiest, just like that. But if you want to really try that, then this is how to do it. What you have to do is pull this paper out like this. You just separate the paper. Be careful not to tear it. So it's like that. And let's, while we're at it, separate on this side too. Okay. And now let's turn back over and just press right on that eye. And hopefully that'll make it a nice round spot right there. And you can just sort of use your hands to try to adjust it. And same thing over here, just press. And try to make it sort of a circle. If you want, you can use the eraser part of the pencil and just help sculpt the eye to taste, the eyeball. And just work on the cheek, try to make all of these folds just kind of flatten. Try to make it as smooth as possible. And up here, that's pretty good like that, but if you want, you can just pinch right here. Flatten here and here. That might give it a little bit more shape. I don't know. And now it just takes sculpting. Yeah, just do your best. I was never much of a sculptor, more of a origami designer, so this real life looking sculpture is not my forte, but I'm doing my best. Thank you. try to get out the folds, so just flatten it so that the folds aren't really visible. It should look smooth. And let's try to make that cleft under the nose. Let's try to make that part again. Yeah, that's getting there. Okay, well, you can mess with it a little bit more, but I'm gonna just end there for the interest of time. Okay, now let's fold this edge down if you want a hairline. If not, just leave it like that. But you can fold this edge down to taste. Perhaps this is a cloak. I don't know what it is. Let's pull the edge out like this. And you can just sort of round it out around this edge by rolling it to taste. And that way the edge will stick out a little bit. Like that. Okay, let's see how this thing works. So, reach in here, and let's push the sword back in. Like that. And exercise it. And I just deformed the space. Wow, that looks pretty scary. Okay, that's a little better. I like it from this side, and it looks better because you don't see these edges. Okay, and that's pretty good. Let's just sculpt the sword a little bit more so that it doesn't just look like a cross. Although, who knows, you might like it like that. Okay, let's take this and let's fold this edge in like that. A little curved fold. And same thing on the bottom. And same thing up here. Little curve. And a curve on the bottom. Like that. And if you want to round this, here's a way to do it. Let's turn it to the bad side. And let's fold this edge down about like this. And let's open this pocket and squash here and squash here. Close it back up, and it's rounded. All right, so there it is. If you want, you can just shape the handle a little bit more to taste. And so there's the model going in and out, and if you put it on the ground, it goes in and out. I think it looks better in your hand because then it can go all the way and your hand can sort of cup it like that. If you find that it's sort of flimsy, one thing that you can do to make it look a little bit better, perhaps, is fold these edges back like this. Just kind of pull them out of view. You can't go too far down, but maybe about like that. Make sure that it still goes in. Yeah, that works. So there it is. All right, well, that's quite an epic model. I hope that you were able to follow it, and I hope it looks halfway decent at least. And if it doesn't, well, you can just call this a rock with a cross and a sword swallowing rock. A sword swallowing tombstone. So there it is. May you fold in peace. And see you later.